Hey guys, welcome back to another Procreate tutorial. Today we'll be doing a Procreate brushes tutorial with the Procreate 5 Brush Studio. If you're new to my channel, welcome. I'm Mad Chen and I'm a digital illustrator. I create Procreate tutorials for beginners. Stick around guys because I'll be showing you how to create your own Procreate brushes in just a few moments. Keep watching until the end of the video as I'll be showing you a bonus Procreate trick as well as additional hacks and Procreate tips. So we're going to start off by creating a simple brush. So the first thing we're going to do is go to the brush library, and we'll need to go down to the calligraphy category and choose the monoline brush. Next, we need to go to color palettes and we need to choose the color black. I don't want to keep this Procreate tutorial too long, so we'll keep it simple by drawing a sample shape for our brush. Because this is just an example, I'll be drawing something simple like a star for today's tutorial. And then I'm just going to fill it in with the color black. So when you're creating any type of shape for your brush, you want to make sure that your shape is completely filled in with black. Next, we go to layers and we click on the plus icon to open up a new layer. And we're going to take this new layer and drag it down under our star shape. Then we need to go back to color palettes and choose white. And then we need to fill in that blank layer with white. So you should be left with two layers, your shape, which my example is a black star on the top, and with the white canvas just underneath. Then what we're going to do is we're going to merge these two layers together. So we're going to select both the star layer and the white canvas layer, and we're going to use two fingers to pinch them together, like so. The next thing we want to do is go to the wrench icon up here in the top left, and then click on PNG, and click on copy. Then we'll come back to layers and we'll toggle off our star shape for now. So now that we have the shape for our brush, let's go back to the brush studio and click on the plus icon here to create a new brush. So the first thing we're going to do in the studio is to upload our shape that we've just created. So over here on the left side, you can see shape. Click on that, which will show you your shape source. At the moment, you can see that our default shape is a circle, but we're going to change that by clicking on edit up here. Now this is where we're going to upload our new star shape. Then we click on import over here, and then we're just going to go down here and click on paste, and you'll see that our shape has been uploaded. Now when working with Procreate brushes, we need these colors to be inverted. So we need the star to be white and we need the canvas to be black. So the way we can do this is pretty simple. All we need to do is take two fingers and tap on the screen to invert the colors. Then you can click on done. So let's go back up here to stroke path and talk about this section. On the right side, we have a drawing pad. And as you can see, the brush stroke that we have here is based on the star shape that we uploaded just before. So this is what it would look like if you were to draw one continuous line. Now, if we look at the middle of the screen, we have stroke properties, and under it we have spacing. If you increase the percentage of spacing, you'll see that our star shapes begin to separate, bringing the percentage back down makes the stars less visible and again creates the solid line. For the next example, I'm going to clear the drawing pad so that you can see what happens when I use streamline. I'm going to draw three arc shapes. So what streamline actually does is it smooths out your lines and curves for you. So when drawing with streamline, you'll see that there's a little bit of a delay because it's trying to approximate how your curves and lines would look best on your screen. I'm going to clear the drawing pad again and draw another squiggly line for our jitter example. So when you use jitter, it actually explodes and spreads out the shape of your brush. So the higher the percentage that you choose for jitter, the more random your brush shape will be spread out across your canvas. So if you want your brush shape to stay in line, you should keep jitter on 0% or on a low percentage. The last one is fall off. Now what this does is it decreases the opacity at the end of your brush stroke. So as you can see, the higher percentage I choose for fall off, the end of my brush stroke becomes less visible. Next, we're going to go into taper because I'm going to create a simple example brush for today. I won't be touching a lot of the settings in the taper section, but just to let everyone know, the taper section allows you to adjust the thickness of your lines and brush strokes. Next is shape, where we were at the beginning. Gonna leave all of these settings the way they are. something really interesting that I want to mention down here. You can move these little nodes to twist your brush. If you look on the drawing pad on the right side, you can see that my brush stroke is twisting. Next is grain. Grain's really interesting because you can choose the texture of your brush. So Procreate has a source library where you can choose from multiple different types of textures for your brush. And the way to get there is we'll click on edit here, and then we click on import, and here we have source library, so we'll click on that. There's a lot of different textures that you can choose from. So for today's example, I'm just going to choose agate, and then I'll click on done. So now we have the agate texture showing up on our brush stroke. Okay, so underneath the textures, we have grain behavior. So you can see here we have two tabs. One is called moving and the other one is texturized. We currently have the moving tab selected, which means that our agate texture will only show up strongly at the beginning of our brush stroke, and it will slowly fade away the further away you get from the starting point of your brush stroke. But what I want from my brush is for the texture to be consistent throughout the entire brush stroke. So what I'm going to do in this situation is click on texturized. So by choosing texturized, you'll see that our texture consistently shows up for the entire length of the brush stroke. Now I'm going to leave the rest of the settings as is. When you get used to creating brushes in the brush studio, you can have a bit of a play around with these settings so that you can see what kind of brushes that you'll come up with. So next we'll go to rendering. I'm gonna keep this part on intense glaze. And down here we have blending. Again, you can play around with these to adjust the flow, how wet your edges are. If you want any burnt edges on your brush, you can adjust the percentage on here. Then we have wet mix. This will be a very useful category for you to play around with. So you can adjust these if you're going to create a watercolor brush. Next, we're going to go to color dynamics. If you want to change the hue, saturation, or the brightness, you can come here and change that here in color dynamics. Next is dynamics, which I'll leave as is. And then we have the Apple Pencil. Here you can adjust the brush behavior. I won't be adjusting any of these settings for my brush, so I'm going to leave it as is. As a beginner, the basic categories that you'll need is stroke path, shape, and grain. Once you get used to using the Brush Studio, you can have a bit of a play around with the other settings. But for now, if you're new to creating brushes, I highly recommend that you play around with the three categories that I mentioned, which are stroke path, shape, and grain. So now let's test our new brush. So we'll go back to canvas and then we'll click on layers and we'll add a new layer, and we're gonna go back to color palettes and choose black. And then I'm just gonna do some random strokes on the canvas just to show you the new brush that we've created. We can see that the texture is showing up well on our brush stroke. We can also use our star brush as a stamp. So as you can see, my star stamps are also showing up with the same texture. Now there's an easier and time efficient way to get a lot of stamps onto your canvas. Go back to the Brush Studio. You can go back to this section here and adjust the spacing. So I'm just gonna adjust the spacing and spread those stars out. Then save that and then come back out to the canvas. I can get the same stamp effect without having to lift my brush off the canvas. So let's add some colors to these stars. So there's a fun way you can add colors to your stamps. Let's start by creating a new layer. I'm going to choose a color from color palettes, and I'm going to choose this reddish orange here. And then we're going to go to the brush library and look for the airbrushing category, and then choose the hard brush. And then we'll go back to canvas and start painting over our blank layer. So I'm just going to keep going back and forth with the pen until I'm happy with the amount of color I've got. And then I'm just going to choose another color, and we'll choose a more orange tone. And then the last color I'm going to choose is green. So to get these colors only on the actual stamps, go back to layers. We're going to click on N here. We're going to search and choose color burn. Color burn will place the color only on your stamp without affecting the canvas. Now this is a pretty good Procreate hack or Procreate tip for when you want to color your brush strokes or your stamps quickly without having to color the entire canvas. Okay, so as a bonus for this Procreate brushes tutorial, I'm going to show you how to create your signature into a stamp. So we're going to come back here to layers and toggle off the current layers that are on. And we're going to create a new layer by clicking on this plus icon here. Then we'll go back to brush library and go back to calligraphy and make sure that you choose the monoline brush. And then we'll come back to color palettes and we'll choose black again. So for this example, I'll be writing my name. And the same way that we did with the star shape, we're going to create a white canvas just underneath my name. And the same way that we did with the star shape before, we're going to merge the white canvas and my name together. Then we're going to copy it. Then we go back to the brush studio and click on the plus icon to create this new brush. So just like before, we'll click on shape first, and then we'll click on edit, and then import, so that we can import the name. Tap on the canvas with two fingers to invert the colors. Click on done. Then we go back to canvas. Again, let's open up a new layer, and then we go to color palettes and choose black so that we can write with black. Sometimes you're going to need to increase the size of your brush if your signature stamp is too small. So I've made my stamp. I'm just going to increase the size of the canvas so that you guys can see. And there it is. So I hope you enjoyed today's Procreate Brushes tutorial. Please share, like, comment, and subscribe to show your support, as myself and my mascots here, Butternut and Soybean, will greatly appreciate it. If you haven't already, you can check out my other Procreate tutorials by clicking on the link above, or you can check out the links in the description below. Thanks for watching, guys, and I hope you have a wonderful day, and I'll see you in the next Procreate tutorial.